everyone.
Welcome to the Elections Committee, New York State Senate, on this Tuesday, February 26th, 2019. We will be discussing a number of bills that increase transparency in both contracting and voting, and look forward to any discussion that we have in this meeting. And the first bill that we will be taking up is S-2300.
S-2300, Senator Kavanaugh's bill, an act to amend the election law in relation to enacting the Voter Friendly Ballot Act and to repeal Section 7-108 of such law relating to the form of ballots.
Any discussion? Motion to move the bill?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
The bill is moved and reported. The next bill is 2333.
S-2333, Senator Kavanaugh's bill, an act to amend the election law in relation to requiring additional transfer and contributor identification information in campaign receipt and expenditure statements.
Any discussion?
Move the bill.
Second?
Second.
The bill is moved and reported. The next is S-3134.
S-3134, Senator Myrie's bill, an act to amend the election law in relation to satisfying filing requirements.
Any discussion? Motion to move?
Move.
Second?
Second.
The bill is moved and reported. The next bill is S-3140.
S-3140, Senator Myrie's bill, an act to amend the election law in relation to publishing local campaign contribution limits.
Any discussion?
I just want to thank you because in local elections, particularly first-time candidates, absolutely know nothing about campaign limits. They don't know, and it's, while it's their obligation to learn something, it's very difficult to find out. So this would be a substantial improvement for local elections and particularly for new candidates, which we want to continue to encourage.
Thank you very much for that, Senator May. And forgive me, I didn't recognize the senators that have joined us this morning. We are joined by Senator May, Senator Mayer, and also Senator Guarnardes, who is visiting us today because we are discussing his bill. I'd also like to thank the State Board of Elections that is with us today as well for their suggestions and work, particularly on this contribution limits bill. The next bill is S-3.
I think you have to move this.
Oh, I'm sorry. Motion to move the bill. Okay, great. The bill is moved and reported. The next bill is S-3145.
S-3145, Senator Myrie's bill, an act to amend the election law in relation to ballot proposals.
Before any discussion, I'd like to recognize Senator Kavanaugh, who has joined us this morning. We have already moved and put it on your previous bills, but you're welcome.
I commend you for
But we are happy to discuss, and you can offer any comments that you'd like as we move forward.
Great.
I'm sorry, any discussion on S-3145?
Move the bill.
Second?
Second.
And the bill is moved and reported. Senator Kavanaugh, did you want to say anything on your earlier bills?
No, I will just say briefly, the Voter Friendly Ballot Act is a bill we've worked on for a long time with a great many advocates are concerned about the readability and usability of ballots, especially in New York City, where they tend to be particularly crowded because of language access issues and because the number of candidates we often have. I think today is a good example of the extent to which ballots can be very crowded in New York. I'm very pleased after a number of years of the Assembly. I think we passed this bill for the first time in 2012 in the Assembly, and it has been pending in the Senate for a long time, so it's terrific that we're moving it today. Thank you for putting it on the agenda.
Great, thank you very much. Motion to move the bill?
Move.
Second?
Which one are we talking about?
Sorry, 3145, is that right?
No, I didn't do that.
This is the bill on ballot proposals, and it would just add some indication on the ballot if there is questions on the back or if there's anything on the back.
Move. So moved.
Or,
second.
Any discussion?
On this bill, I would just ask that we take a look at the extent to which it may overlap with the Voter Friendly Ballot Act.
Mm-hmm.
I think especially the requirement about an arrow for the for when things are on the other side may be addressed in non-identical language in the Voter Friendly Ballot Act. And that bill, the Voter Friendly Ballot Act has passed the Assembly this year, so if we move it forward, it's likely to be
great.
Enacted. So we just check to conform the requirements of this to that.
Great. We'd be happy to do so, Senator. Thank you. So did we move that bill?
Yeah, we moved and seconded.
Seconded, and there was discussion. Okay, the bill is moved and reported. The next bill is S-3167.
S-3167, Senator Myrie's bill, an act to amend the election law in relation to government and vendor contributions.
Any discussion? And I think this is an important step to increase transparency in our contracting process. I think most people are aware of some of the pitfalls and some of the examples of when we are not transparent and what can happen and possibly corrupting factors in this process. So I think this is a first step in ensuring that people aren't using campaign money to influence the contracting process. Motion to move the bill.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All right, the bill is moved and reported. And last but certainly not least, S-3697.
S-3697, Senator Gennardis' bill, an act to amend the election law in relation to campaign funds for use at a business owned by a candidate or the candidate's family.
I will allow the senator to offer any comments if you'd like.
Thank you, Senator Myrie. This basically, you know, extends, we don't allow candidates or elected officials to take campaign dollars and put the money right in their pocket. This says that we're not going to let you put the money into the pockets of your family members. So it really is a logical next step in making sure that we're protecting the integrity of our elections and ensuring that no one who is pursuing public office is doing so for private gain. There have been egregious examples of this in the past, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars going to family businesses, and that should have been illegal a long time ago. And I think by passing this bill, we are taking an unequivocal stand that this type of behavior is no longer considered, you know, acceptable.
Thank you. Any further discussion?
Just a question. So I know we've heard about a lot of this at the federal level, but this will apply to state level.
State candidates, and it's 2 degrees of family separation. So it's, you know, a parent-sibling relationship or a parent-child relationship or a sibling relationship. So this doesn't apply if your third cousin owns the local whatever. You know, this is really that tight-knit where there's so much overlap.
Can you just talk about what is a degrees of sanguine?
So it's 2 degrees is either parent, child, or sibling. That's, I guess.
Not a cousin.
Not a cousin.
So your first cousin would not be.
Would not fall into this category, yeah.
Can I just ask a question? The senator may just reference state election. Does this, it also applies to local elections as well, does it not?
Any elections that are covered by our campaign finance laws and the state campaign finance laws.
Fine. And the last question is, has the State Board of Elections given their opinion about this?
Not to my knowledge.
This would include, like, you couldn't have somebody within this definition of family staffing your campaign?
No, this is about spending campaign dollars, you know, at businesses that you or your family members own. So this is related specifically to businesses that are owned. So, you know, you couldn't, if you owned a business, you couldn't hire your own business through your campaign and basically put the money back in your pocket. Now we're saying if your family member owns a business, you can't do the same.
So if the person owned a consulting firm, you couldn't hire that consulting firm.
You couldn't hire
somebody as an individual employee.
Sure, right, yeah. Or subject to whatever other restrictions may exist. But this specifically applies to businesses and the expenditure of campaign funds at family-owned businesses.
Moved the bill.
Second.
The bill is moved and reported. I believe that concludes our discussion for today. Thank you all for attending, and we will see you next time.
Thank you.
Thank you.